Hello, and welcome to the second episode of my new Devlog series about the development of an Android simulator game called Lia. In this episode, you'll see how the shop looks and how it communicates with the building system, how I modified the whole editing mode, and also get some tips on how and where to find graphics for your game. So let's dive in! I started this week's development with choosing some graphics for the game, because it wouldn't be so exciting if there were just squares. Here's a tip for you. Make or choose graphics as you make the game. It will help you with motivation to actually continue working on this game and eventually finish it. But where to get the graphics if you can't draw and you don't have a budget? It turns out that there are plenty of graphical assets available for free. You have probably heard about Unity Asset Store. Artists usually sell their works there, but if you check the free assets, you can find some good packs to your taste. I found a big pack with different houses that I plan on using in my game. However, on the next website that I searched was a beautiful pack of trees, which are just perfect for my desired style, so I might remake the houses to match them. The next asset source that I wanted to show you is Eachiowa. In general, it is a platform where you can publish your games, but if you go to the Assets tab and select Free, you can find some awesome assets. Here I found the trees and a few UI packs for the game shop interface. All the links to packs that I used in my game are in the description box below the video. This week I worked on the development of the game shop. This includes UI part and the actual functionality. Firstly, I started with UI part. I found a good tutorial on how to make a responsive UI in Unity. I left the link to it in the description. The next thing I did was shop tabs for different categories. I also found a tutorial and implemented it in my game. At this point, UI looks raw, but I replaced it later on. Wait to the end of the video to see the final result. As I was developing the UI, I inquired a problem where I couldn't scale the viewport properly. It was always leaving out a few items behind. The tutorial I used showed how to make vertically scrolling items, but I needed horizontally. I googled and found that in Unity, horizontal scaling doesn't work the same as vertical. But someone was kind enough to leave a script solution for this. Huge thanks to this person! As for the functionality, I made shop items to be loaded from scriptable objects that contain a prefab, which will be used for building if you buy the item. I also redone the editing mode, because it didn't work well with item placement from the shop. Now it works through the event manager. Shop or editing mode invokes an event of object placement. Building system listens for it and receives which object it has to instantiate. Next, two events are possible, building placed and placement cancelled. They are invoked after a button click and get back to the original color, shop or editing mode. I would really advise to implement the event system in your game, because it is a good practice. I still haven't found the perfect solution for myself, but it is a way to go. This is how the game looks now. We have two buttons, one for the shop and one for the editing mode. We can buy different buildings and decor in it and place them on our map. We can go to the editing mode, select a building with long touch and move it around and place on a new spot. This is it for this week. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel to see future devlogs, and I'll see you next week. Bye!